All right, back for game three with a healthy 13 minutes. I'm going to keep this hand. This is another hand that has a chance of just not doing anything. But whatever. Like, we have sleight of hand. Nice. And the opponent doesn't have a threat, which is just the most important thing. I'm petrified of Swift Spear. Like, that card is hard to kill. But as for this hand, we've got two Caryatids, two Ascendancies, and a Shoal to force it through. It's just a matter of whether we find the lands, really. And the right blue spells. Well, this is a tough call. First of all, last game we were gifted with just kind of getting there. Actually, let's take the Izzetrarm. Well, this is really tough, because the question of... yeah, let's take the Izzetrarm so that we have a 2 for Disrupting Shoal. The question right now is whether we would want to counter a Pyromancer. I probably wouldn't, because eventually, in order to win this game, we're going to need to draw a second mana at some point, and Pyroclasm is going to be really good. All right, well, there's a Delver. Hopefully we draw land at some point. 8 cards in hand, so that's rough. 3 Caryatids, and I didn't want it to end like this, but it seems to be the way that it's ending. I'm gonna have 6. So, we could play more than 18 lands and 2 Spirit Guides, or we could have Mulliganed. Those are things that we could do. It's definitely, like, gets away with playing really land light most of the time, but not always. I mean, I did board out the Thought Scours as well. This game is not over, though, because we still have the Clasms. We could draw a green source and just get there. Okay, well, the opponent is not cracking their Scalding Tarn before playing the Serum Vision, so if they keep a card on top and they have to crack the Scalding Tarn, they're going to lose it. So hopefully we draw something and can cast something. Take 1. My Kingdom for any land. Like, if it casts green, awesome. If it's Dryad Arbor, ew. Okay, well, we're behind. Green and white seems like what we want. Play Caryatid. It's in play, well. Well, the opponent's just got a lot of spell pierces and bolts and stuff, maybe. Thinking about how we actually combo. There's a spell pierce. Well, we have Izzetrarm and Pyroclasm. 3. That thing might just kill us before we get the mana, though. We might need to, like... yeah. That Mist Land drop was pretty brutal. If we draw a land the next turn, then maybe we're in okay shape. Or maybe we can just cast Ascendancy. No, that's not going to happen because of the Pierce. Oh. Opponent got the attack. Was hoping they would miss it. At 11. Pass the turn. So Spirit Guide is pretty sweet. That could maybe save us. I'm going to play a Caryatid. And pass the turn. We can Spirit Guide out an Izzetrarm if we really need to. But we can probably wait a turn. Well, the opponent's Spell Pierce. They would need to be totally tapped. But it's an option. Okay, well, Operation Force Through a Removal Spell, and then hope that the opponent can't replace it or takes a while to do so. I want to see the opponent tap mana to play another creature. That would be the ideal. Forked Bolt to 6. Well, that's pretty scary. Cataxian Probe, so I don't really want to play that very bad. Could play Jeskai Ascendancy, and then Simian Spirit Guide to play for Spell Pierce, and then Disrupting Shoal to play for a 2-mana counter, and then we would have Cataxian Probe left over, Cataxian Probe, Chasm, and Ascendancy left over. We could probe going to 4 life, and then Chasm. That seems like maybe worth doing. Alternatively, we could Pyroclasm. I think I would prefer just playing Chasm. Like, we don't need to combo off, and we don't need to throw nearly as many resources if we're just trying to kill that aberration. So, I mean, we're fighting despite that missed land. We are indeed fighting. Spell Pierce. Start off by paying for it. And then we can Disrupting Shoal. And then maybe the opponent just doesn't have another creature. Doesn't have two burn spells. Another Spell Pierce. Counter that Spell Pierce with a Disrupting Shoal. F6. Hope for the best. Opponent only has three cards left, so I mean they may have a Treasure Cruise, but and we might get burned out, but like I can imagine how this game would have gone pretty smoothly if here's Bolt, we're probably dead. If we had hit that land, then maybe we would have been fast enough. Did we have an opportunity to Disrupting Shoal Delver? I don't think so. Alright, well GG's. It was a good match.